Kingsburg, a glorious realm, a vast realm, a realm that is ever expanding. You need a lot of help. To forge a realm. Hello and welcome to the Bottled Imp, exploring the realms of fantasy. My name is Ken Boyter, and today we are looking at the expansion, can I even say the word? It's going to be a good review, folks. We are looking at To Forge a Realm, it's the expansion for Kingsburg. Now, you do need the base game of Kingsburg, which we have done a lovely little review on, so you go check that out. And this Kingsburg is a worker placement game. Basically, you're trying to get victory points, and you have various different influences that you can take from the court. So there are people in the court, in the kingdom, that you need to go to get various building resources. And once you've got those, you can build your buildings. So check out the base game review, and then you can check out this review to forge a realm. Let's have a look. So just what is in the To Forge a Realm expansion for Kingsburg base game box? Let's have a look. Well, first of all, you get, because it's Fantasy Flight, you do get lovely, full kind of colour, full illustrated and detailed rule book that goes through every single thing in the box and how to play the expansion with the base game. You get five different modules, and they are broken down like this. First up, well, in no particular order, I should say, we have the player mats. Now, these player mats actually differ from the original base game. So this is the base game mat. And as you can see, there are two extra additional rows of buildings. So every player gets one of those. You have soldier tokens, and these little soldier tokens have different numbers on them, but we'll go into detail a little bit further down the line. And every player gets one, a set of those. You also get 14 building rows, and some of them are duplicated. And you get governor cards, a big stack of those, nice pack of those. And you also get destiny cards. So there we are. Those are the five modules. Now you can play them separately, so you can just add one module or two or three or four, or you can play with the whole five modules. Let's take a look at them in a little bit more detail. So as I say, the player board here, the actual area that the players will be building their buildings, has increased by two rows. So there's an additional two more rows, which obviously gives you much more strategy involved in the game, and it means that you can decide what you want to do, a different kind of strategy. So it just adds more of the same. And obviously, if you're trying to build different buildings, I really, really love the fact that there's just more choice to this, you know, the actual player area. Then we have these rows. And what you do with these is you shuffle them and you actually place them face down and you spread them all out. And then each player takes turns in taking two of the rows at random. So for example, if I took those two, what I would do is I would look at these and I would think, is that going to improve my player area? Are these buildings better than the ones I actually have on the standard player area board? So if I decide yes, I can take one, two, or I don't have to take any of them. So if I decide to take one of them, then I would look at what row it is. So there's a little E on this one. So I would then simply cover that row up. And then if I wanted to take this one, this is C. So I would do the same and I would cover that one up. So the row underneath both of those is not going to be in play for me. And that's a great little expansion because it means that obviously not everybody will have exactly the same buildings. If you pick two of the same, so say you picked, you know, two row C's, then you can put one of them back and pick another one. Next up, we have the soldier tokens. Now, this is a great little module because in the base game, when you have to fight the monsters, the creatures at the end of the year, you are building up your soldier tokens, your attack roll basically, and you need to get the same or higher than the monsters, and that's determined by a card that you flip over at the end. the king also comes in to help you. He sends some troops, and the way you do that in the base game is you roll a die. Now, obviously, that's a little bit random because it can reward people that haven't really been collecting the soldier tokens if they've been a bit lazy. And if the king, if someone rolls a six for the king's help, then you kind of think, oh, well, that's not fair. I've been spending building resources on those, you know, soldiers. And then somebody who's been a bit lazy just bowls in and the king helps them. With these, that's about to change, because basically these are different numbers. So we've got a zero, we've got two ones, and what else we've got? Yeah, two ones, and we've also got a three and a four. And what you do is everybody selects one in secret, and then that is how many extra soldiers that you get. So obviously, if you think you've got enough soldiers, or you know you've got enough soldiers, because you can look some areas, you're allowed to look at the card and find out what the monsters are, you might just think, well, I'll play a zero that round because, you know, I don't need to waste any of my soldiers here. But you have to bear in mind that whatever token you are left with, because there's one more than you need, that is extra victory point bonuses. So, you know, you might want to try and keep your four till the end and actually have four victory points. So that's a great little way. It adds more strategy. It takes the luck element of rolling a dice out, and it does encourage people to actually, you know, concentrate on their soldiers a little bit more. Then we have the destiny cards. Now, these destiny cards, I really enjoyed playing with these, because what you do is you shuffle these at the beginning of the game, and at the beginning of each year, you will simply flip over the top one, and then you will read it aloud. In this case, it says, fierce enemies. Enemies have plus one in battle. And these destiny cards are in effect for the whole of that year. So obviously, when the monsters come up, they will have plus one. For example, this one says, the king sends two soldiers as reinforcements. Do not roll the die for the king. What's this one? That's a long one. Hey, at the beginning of each productive season, roll one die. With the result of four or more, each player receives one stone. So there are some good ones. There are some kind of not so good ones. But that just adds another layer, another bit of strategy that you have to cope with. And then we have the governor cards. And what you do is you shuffle them, and you will then, each player gets dealt two, and then they will select one of those to keep and actually play as their governor card. And once everybody selected them, you flip them over and you reveal them. So for example, the noble. Now he begins the game with six extra victory points. And that's, you know, that just gets added at the beginning. So he's pretty cool. This one says you get plus one in battle. And let's have a look at this one. Oh, that's quite a long one. So some have got longer special abilities, as we are finding out, than others. So some are quite simple, like you get extra victory points or you get plus one in battle. Some are kind of a little bit more complicated. But there are quite a lot here. So there's lots of choice that you can potentially get. And basically, these add a little bit more strategy. And again, it means that the individual playing is slightly different. So not everybody starts off the same. It's an asymmetrical game, it becomes. And the other thing with these cards is they give you one blank card each. So there's a blank destiny card, and there is a blank governor card. And obviously you can create your own if you so wish to. We haven't yet, I guess, because we haven't thought of any. But it could be, you know, do not collect £200, something like that. Who knows? So there we go. That is the five modules right there. We absolutely love these modules, and because we play Kingsburg a lot, we just decided to dive straight in there and actually just play with all five straight away. I personally wouldn't play it without these expansions now, without every single module, because it adds so much more variety to it. As I said, each player now, it feels slightly different, so you're playing a slightly different strategy, maybe, for example. because of the governor cards, you know, you have your own little special ability. And because of these random, you know, these actual random extra rows, they actually obviously means that not every single building area will be the same because you're covering different buildings. And therefore, the choice is so much greater. And once again, as I said, these soldier tokens take out that randomness of the roll die for the king. Unless there were new people playing Kingsburg, I wouldn't shove them all in if it's somebody new, if you're playing, you know, if you want to introduce somebody to the game. You might put one or two of them in, like, for example, you could put the governor cards in, or you could put the soldier tokens in, and then you can increase that as they get more and more proficient with the game. But if you've played Kingsburg lots, you just want to dive straight in. I totally, totally recommend To Forge a Realm. Kingsburg, To Forge a Realm expansion set from Fantasy Flight. Totally recommend it. As I say, we have done Kingsburg the base game. Check that review out. And we're on all the usual social media malarkey. Check us out there. Thanks once again for watching. And remember, as always, definitely, definitely keep it unreal.